Senior Research Engineer Kurt Long has kindly offered his miniature wind tunnel for testing.
There we go.
Perfect.
All right, just bolt it down and we're ready to go.
All right.
But ready to go with what exactly?
This may look pretty cool, but I assure you that yesterday this was nothing but a big sheet of steel with potential.
And it didn't take long for that steel to fulfill its potential, transforming into a small-scale house. Like most simple homes, it's got four walls, a roof, and some windows. But this is an engineering marvel.
All of the walls of the house have a hinge along the bottom, and that allows the wall to flex in and out. Now, because we've attached a cylinder inside that's filled with a blue fluid, when the wall moves in or out, it pushes that cylinder up or down, which moves this blue fluid in the hose up or down. Now, because the cylinder is actually quite large and this hose is quite small, we get a lot of movement on the hose that we can see clearly with relatively little movement on the wall.
Each wall and the roof is color-coded, so the blue water runs up a clear tube to match a corresponding color on the big board. That way, they can see exactly which wall is feeling the force of the wind with windows open or closed.
This steel box right here is our test platform for monitoring pressures on a house when the windows are open or closed in a windstorm. It's got four windows, one on each side, and we can open them by removing any which ones we want.
Time to test the relative pressures from several hurricane window scenarios, and we'll kick it off with a total lockdown.
Now, this test is with all windows closed, and this will be our baseline for all the other testing.
Kurt starts the suction, raising the wind speed in an instant to 60 feet per second. The tail of the turbulence couldn't be more clear.
Baby, there you go.
With all windows closed, the front wall bore the brunt of the blast. The roof began to lift, and the blue water went wild.
The roof is lifting just a little bit.
That's exactly what we'd expect. I think we're good. We can bring it down.
That's perfect. Let's cut it.
So they stopped the mini hurricane, resetting the tiny house with all windows open.
So the myth is that leaving your windows open in a hurricane will result in less structural damage to your house. If this myth is true, when we run this test with all the windows of our test house out, we should see a lot less movement of all the sides.
Once again, Kurt cranks the breeze up to 60 feet per second. And the movement, as predicted, is minimal. The walls and the water barely budge.
That's coming down just a hair.
Yeah. A lot less stress with the windows open.
Yep.
So, windward side pushed in 8.5 inches, a lot less than last time. The roof pushed up just a tiny bit.
Everything was less.
Everything was less with the windows open rather than closed.
And that's good news for the myth. With all windows open, some of the wind blew clean through the house. Less pressure on the walls and roof should mean less damage. But this typhoon test isn't restricted to all or nothing.
Next.
Only the windward window open, all the others closed.
Adam and Jamie try out a range of single window options. First, they just open the one up front.
60 feet a second, zero.
Then they try a side window.
Beautiful.
And finally, they remove the one out back.
I feel like I'm birthing a mechanical cow.
But all windows open is still by far the best option.
Nothing, 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 nothing. It's all in that front space.
Yep.
I've seen everything I need to see. You want to call it?
Yep.
All right. The single worst thing you can do in a windstorm is open the windward side window and none other. Your house feels like a balloon. It puts a maximum amount of stress on the structure. It turns out that in this test, the least amount of stress on your house will result from you opening all of your windows.